So the next time I get something, tell Brian. Is Brian there? Oh, yes, he is. Okay. If you want to unmute channel on that iMac, then you'll start hearing stuff. getting a bit new.
Probably courage and strength to those who are seeking to bring about justice and protect innocence, both in the country of Afghanistan and all around the world. We pray for those victims who are injured that they might be granted healing, and for those families who will be grieving that you will comfort them. We pray that you will prepare and equip all who seek to fight this holy war for the good of mankind. And we pray this in the name of the God who created us all. Amen. And now finally, I just want to point out what is probably obvious to you, that this is not a public facility. It's private property. It is a space owned by this church and dedicated as a house of worship. And according to the bylaws of our congregation, everything that happens within these walls, we require to be done consistent with Judeo-Christian values, including mutual respect and decorum. And therefore, we just want you to know that we're going to hold to that, reserve the right. If anyone acts in a verbally or physically abusive way or disruptive to the peace of this gathering, we will ask you to desist. We gather here as Americans who have more in common than can possibly divide us. And therefore, it is with that spirit and underlying unity that we look forward to this time we will spend together. I would like now to turn things over to our moderator, Rod Kieseski, and to Congressman Rooney.
Southwest Florida, Congressman Francis Rooney. great gift of our founders to each and every one of us. It gives us a right of free speech and free expression, but it also imposes an obligation on us to respect and accept the free speech of others, even though we violently disagree with them. We are the only country in the world that nurtures free speech to this extent. We're also the only country in the world that nurtures freedom of the press to the extent that we do. And I happen to think that free speech and freedom of the press, along with freedom of religion, the first three freedoms mentioned in the First Amendment, are defining issues for our country and make us in large part what we are. So I thought I would start by giving a little rundown of what we've been doing for the last 4 months since y'all sent me up there. The media has said at times that Congress was deadlocked and wasn't accomplishing anything. So I thought I'd put up a couple of slides and show you that in the first 100 days, we have passed more bills in the House than any of the preceding four presidents.
Understands our needs here. And we've talked to them that whatever
private sector program the NFIP adopts must have a federal backstop that's at a reasonable cost where our folks here can buy flood insurance at an affordable cost, because the Fed, you know, if you're in the match, you've got to buy the flood insurance. So it's not fair for the government to say you have to buy the flood insurance, but then not make it affordable for you. The goal is going to be to create a private sector market for flood insurance, which over time may obviate the necessity of the federal government. But nobody in Florida, not one of your elected officials in the House, feel that we can go without the federal government behind us right now. And that's the point that we've been making to the subcommittee that deals with this in the House. And this is going to be coming up pretty soon, because the law that saved flood insurance a few years ago is about to expire in September. That's why I wanted to bring it to your attention. Third local issue I thought I might mention briefly is the offshore drilling ban. You know, when I was here for Congress, they said you're for offshore drilling because you own a drilling company, oil and gas, and all this kind of stuff. But I'm not. I'm not because after Obama.
Done deal that obligates the United States to do a bunch of jobs.
for the jobs in America.
There's also a lot of money. Money's going to be cut across.
choice.
The attendees are very passionate and also very angry, but most of all, very scared of what the future holds under this administration. I would like to know, what is your vote going to be in regards to cuts to Medicare, Social Security, Medicaid, food stamps, disability benefits, VA benefits? I don't know if you're aware how many seniors in nursing homes depend upon Medicaid, or that almost all foster children in the nation are on Medicaid. And the people on Social Security disability, most of them are on Medicare as their primary and Medicaid as their secondary. And the second part of my question is, can you tell us an example when you voted for country over party?
and Cheryl Drumgoole. Drumgoole? Okay, I apologize again. Sometimes the handwriting is mixed. I guess to make waves to the aisles, I believe it would be Nancy.
Okay, thank you for the town hall that you're supporting tonight. I appreciate that. Release of the president's tax returns would assure the American
Yeah.
are often failing schools and does not support public education, was chosen to lead public education.
I'm going to balance what's best for the people of District 19 personally believe is right and what's best for the United States.
Thank you.
country. I want to know why you and your body would look at 560,000 physicians and medical students who have pleaded with you and begged you to not pass this inherently flawed bill and explain to you how much harm, great harm, I'm quoting, would do to the people of this country, to their patients. Why is it that you think that enough time has been paid to healthcare? Your whole plan is all about cutting benefits for people who are in great need, children, mothers, senior citizens, as I said, so many people. And now, on top of it, Section 205, it says this section repeals the penalties for certain large employers who do not offer full-time employees and their dependents minimum essential health coverage under an employer-sponsored health plan. This is from your bill. I want to know why you think that that is okay.
Michael Evans, yeah, man, there are 400 liters of this. Michael Evans. And then we'd like to ask Phyllis Tino and Ed Finnan, please stand and make their ways to the aisles.
My question is about reform spirits, about the Joint Resolution 34, which passed the Senate, passed the House with your vote, and is currently law. The resolution allows internet service providers to sell the personal information of their customers without their customers' consent. Now, I'm going to point out that internet service providers are different from other companies and that they are usually monopolies and that the internet is a vital utility in the 21st century and not an optional luxury. So with those facts in mind, my question is, why did you vote for it?
Senator Grassley has referred Planned Parenthood body part business to the DNC.
Congressman, I know you have a lot better things to do with your life than put up with this. GOP, the Republicans are at a crossroads now. They have a golden opportunity to actually write history.
Good question. That's what I'm
People say this is a cut to Medicare or some kind of standard thing. It's not. It's a transfer of the phase out of the Medicare expansion means the states that expanded Medicare, once their subsidies expire, are going to have to raise their own taxes. It's their problem. You're in Florida. If you don't like what Florida's spending on Medicare, you need to elect people that are going to spend more.
What can we do?
goods and services, health, and everything else than any other country, it's still the best way to go. I don't believe in socialism, and I didn't like what's happened the last 8 years. So what can we do?
Since the G7 conference, where three events happened, which I
where we would support our allies should they be attacked. Secondly, he chastised our allies for getting less than the 2% monetary NATO fund. And yet, at the same time, he did not even mention human rights violations when he listed the salaries.
Staffed up the state